morning, ma'am, and everyone present here. Myself, NEETA THUNE, a research scholar, and my research topic is design of low-power PCM, Australia's coded modulation and decoder for the wireless application under the valuable guidance of Dr. S. N. Harda, sir. Before going on to the D, first we should know what is TCM. TCM stands for Kelly's coded modulation, and when we are combining a modulation unit and a encoding unit in a single system, this will become TCM. Generally, the encoding technique preferred is a convolution encoder, and the modulation technique preferred is the APSK modulation or the above high level modulations. TCM is having application in both wireless and wireline application, but the preferred application for my work, I choose the wireless application area, and the next one is the satellite communication. This is the basic block diagram of the TCM system. At the transmitter end, we are having channel encoder, mapper and modulator. Similarly, the information is going to pass through the channel, and at the receiver end, we are having the reverse process, demodulator, demapper and Viterbi decoder. So all of you please keep in mind that we are having a Viterbi decoder. So this is the transmitter one and the receiver one. So the next question is, why we need the TCM? As we know, every communication, whether it is a wireless communication or a wired communication, attenuation, distortion, interference are the major problems. And to avoid this or to mitigate this, we are using error correcting codes. But what is the basic problem with the ECC? If you are looking for the power limited application, then bandwidth will be high. And if you are looking for the bandwidth limited application, power will be high. So, or vice versa, problems are there. If you are looking for the Kelly's coded system, we need to maintain the balance in between the required bandwidth and power. Because in every communication system, the major factors we need to reduce or we need to conserve is the power and the bandwidth. So the suggested scheme is the TCM, maintaining the balance in between the bandwidth and power. Then next part, how my Kelly's coded system is better. Here we are able to achieve the asymptotic coding gain of 5.5 dB, which is acceptable everywhere in communication. Then the second one, we are getting the improved bit error versus SNR in comparison to the traditional ECC method. The next one, here in the system we are achieving the flexible rates. Due to the use of the flexible rates, the advantage we are getting into the system, it is more immune to the noise reversal or phase noise reversal at the receiver end. And as we are as my decoder, because the flexible rates I am using here, and due to this, my decoder should work on the high speed. And if my decoder is working on the high speed, then automatically high data rate I am getting. So that is the achievable thing, because in every system we require high data rate, in every application we require high data rate. So these are the some enlisted advantages, and that's why I start working on it. Now the problem, as I already told you, look onto the block diagram of the system. At the receiver end, we are having a Viterbi decoder part. And as we know, the major power consuming module of any receiver section is a Viterbi decoder. So in my system also, what I thought, in the Viterbi decoder, the transition matrix unit and active select unit, which are the major block bottleneck where you are having repetitive computations. So I decided just to re-implement it in such a way that should reduce the power at the receiver end. So my problem statement is just to mitigate or minimize the power dissipation at the receiver end by using suitable technique. Now, so majorly my problem definition is I just want to reduce the dynamic power. Slowly or lightly I worked on the leakage power also, but my major problem definition is by applying any suitable power reduction technique just to reduce the dynamic power. Now the objectives of my research work is...
How are you this thing taking care of the leakage power?
Ma'am, I am just reducing some of the parameters, but as I told, I am majorly working on... Yeah, because this is that I kept only in my future works, because this will be a research work topic itself. Now right now I am working on dynamic. My future work is to work on the leakage power, ma'am. Now to investigate the design of TCM decoder which consume less power, then the results what I am getting, just want to verify it because I am working on correct direction or not. Then comparing the performance, then compatibility with the existing system, then try to achieve good data rate. So whatever the existing or reported data rate in the literature survey or in existing system, my major aim is to improve the data rate in spite of reducing the dynamic power and improve the data rate. Means I am just maintaining the balance between the data rate and the power consumption. So I decided to search for the system, and this TCM, the application I have chosen, that is satellite communication. So there it is, a CCSDS, which is a consecutive committee for space data system, have given some list of bandwidth efficient modulation. And into that list, if you are looking, this is the frequency range, 8025 to 8400 MHz, and the suggested bandwidth efficient modulation is a 4-dimension 8 PSK TCM. So the application I have chosen for my work is this 4-dimension TCM. Now, I did many literature survey. So instead of putting onto this table, I just skipped the important things which I needed. So I just compared the data rate because I want to improve the data rate. So power consumption, some paper I got. So I put it onto this table. So I keep in mind, these are the work done already, and my major work is to improve that existing work and to implement in my method. This is my basic paper. So I have chosen this paper, the application implemented in paper, I have re-implemented it with my architecture. Then the design flow, as I know, because it's a high data rate application, so obviously my system should work on high clock frequency. Then in the base paper I reported a data rate, one of the data rate is 770 megabits. So I thought my data rate or achieved data rate should be greater than this. That will be my achievement. And my design is based on this green book, that is CCSDS specifications. So now this CCSDS specification, given the specification for the encoder system. So you need to implement that encoder depending on the specification, and at the receiver end, you are free to design your own receiver. So these are the specifications for the encoder. So as I said, I'm using an 8 PSK modulation technique here. So the constellation size is 8. Then number of states for using for training encoder is 64, because my constant length is 7. So 64 states will be there. Then rate of modulation here, another good thing I already enlisted this. There is a flexible rates I'm getting into the system. So first of all, whatever serial data is coming, I need to convert into the parallel one. And that parallel bit, the bunch of bit will be, sometimes it may be 8, sometimes it may be 9, sometimes it may be 10, and sometimes it may be 11. So I have implemented such a system in which I am giving 11 bit as an input. So if I am mitigating or if I am making above 2 bits, 1 or 2 bits, 0, 0, then I am getting all the rates into my single system. So I have approached for the higher one, and I am getting all the, I can work with the all rate of modulation systems. Now the R effective, how I am getting this R effective?
You did not go for a reconfigured value.
It can be reconfigured. It can be reconfigurable, but my major work, I worked on decoding part, so I just implemented.
I'm not concentrated,
but it can be a reconfigured part. This can be become another good project. Now, how I'm getting this efficiency of modulation, this is R effective. As I told, I'm working on the 4-dimension, 4D TCM. So, at a time, how many symbols I'm getting? I'm getting 4 symbols. So if I am choosing 8 bit, then 8 divided by 4.
4 dimensions you are considering?
Yes ma'am?
4 dimensions in that?
Yeah, 4 dimensions. 4 dimension means, not like this. 4 dimension means set of symbols I am getting. So there will be 12 output bits, and for one symbol there will be 3 bit. So there is a one symbol of 3 bit, 3 bit, 3 bit, and likewise I am getting a 4 dimension. So R effective will become 2 bits, 2.25 bits, if I am choosing one of the rate given above. Now, this is my basic block diagram of 4D 8 PSK TCM encoder. Now, as I chosen 11 by 12 modulation rate, so my 11 bits are there. We need to do serial to parallel conversion, then there will be a differential encoder. So what is the need of this? If you are looking onto this, the mapping equations, so in the mapping equation, I am having this part. So x to the power 11, x to the power 8, x to the power 4 means 11 number bit 8 number bit and 4 number bit only have any coefficient 1, 1, 1, 1. Means these bits are more, these bits are more prone to the noise and they can show the noise phase reversal at the receiver end. So only W11 means bit number 11, bit number 8, bit number 4 are sent to the differential encoder only, and rest of the 11 bits are passing to the next part. The next part is the convolution encoder. The convolution encoder is systematic convolution encoder are used, and the design of this convolution encoder is based on these coefficients. So these are polynomial coefficients I am having. Systematically I have implemented with the constant length 7. I am getting one another extra bit, that is x0. So now at this moment I am changing my 11 bit passing through this convolution encoder, it is going to convert into 12 bits. Now, the next part is the constellation mapper. Now, what is the need of this convolution encoder, constellation mapper? As we are increasing the modulation, levels of modulation, then what will happen, ma'am? The Euclidean distance between the constellation is going to be reduced. If the Euclidean distance is going to be reduced, then gain is to be going to reduce. So, just to maintain that particular gain which is accepted by everywhere, I use this constellation mapper. This constellation mapper has been suggested by Engerbo. Depending on that formulas or rules given by that scientist, the constellation mapper has been designed. And then after this constellation mapper, the set of 3-3 bits is coming out, and that bit is going to be modulated and sent through the channel. So I have first of all to check the feasibility of the system. I implement the whole system into the simulink, and some part of the four dimension encoded symbol generation part I have taken. I take a snapshot of it, and it is generating 4 symbols. It is need to be work. This to be a real time system. Then to give the feel of the receiver end, I have designed a simulink also, and just want to check. So what basically I am doing with this simulink thing, I am generating the sample data, because for us to get the satellite stream here, it is impossible. So I have given 100 Mbps of data as an input to the simulink, and I have recorded that into the text file, and this text file I am applying as a input to the PhDL dispatch. So this is some of the snapshot I took into the simulink. So this is my 8 PSK constellation. This is my received constellations.
Did you put it there? Is
This is the eye diagram, and by showing the eye diagram, it is there. The symbols or symbols are just matching up with each other. So we need to do the precaution at the receiver end. We need a synchronizer first, and then we need to synchronize the symbols, and then we need to synchronize the system, and then we need to do the further processing. So at the decoder end. The same system I implemented also VHD, I think VHDL also. So this is the ideal view of the encoding system. And here is the timing diagrams of the received symbols. So I am getting the 4 dimensional symbols here. Now this is the work. Basically I am focusing on it, and my research topic is related to this. So similarly at the receiver end, This would be the my block diagram. And in the block diagram, first one is a transition matrix unit. So the receiver end, the decoder part, is divided into 2 sections. First one to demodulate the receive symbols, and second one to decode it. So first, the demodulation part I did with my simulink, store the data and apply as input to this. So in the transition matrix unit, again receive symbols to be converted into in phase and quadrature phase symbols. So 4 symbols I am getting here. So transition matrix unit, I am generating the branch matrix for the bit repeat decoder. So generation of the branch matrix is taking place into the TAB unit. So as I told, there is a 2 to the power 12 bits, means 12 incoming bits are there. And if you are looking with the traditional type of method, how many calculations we need to do? 2 to the power 12 is 4096. So it will become, it will make my system more complex. So instead of working on 4096 branch matrix, with the help of auxiliary trailing concept, I am working only with the 16 branch matrix. And the 16 branch matrix are the combinations of x3, x2, x1, x0, which are the lower bits of my system. Now, here, if we are implementing straightforward, the number of additions will 768. And if you are working with the auxiliary trailing, automatically the number of additions is going to be reduced. So, if addition is going to be reduced, the hardware part is going to be reduced. Now, this is the systematic one and soft decision with a decoder we are using. So for soft decision with a decoder, we need to prepare the gradient distance. As I told, four dimensions are there, four symbols have been received, and all received symbols is to be matched with the constellation, the real constellation of APSK. And we need to prepare the equivariant distance. The formula for equivariant distance computation is the same, everyone knows this. But instead of working on this formula, if you are closely observed that this part is same for every received symbol. This part is same for every received system. So instead of working on this, if I will find, instead of finding of minimum of this, if you find maximum of this, then it will be altogether good. And again here you are saving the addition part or the reduction in the hardware part. So I will finding out the maximum of this instead of minimum of this. Now this is the auxiliary trailing concept for branch matrix computations. And the distances we are getting from all the four dimensions are based on these equations. C0, C1, C2, C3, these are the four Euclidean distances from all the four dimensions I have already specified. So this kind of auxiliary trailing, we have 14 auxiliary trailing in our block. So after calculation of branch matrix, I will move on to the Viterbi part. So this is the Viterbi part. There is an ad compare select unit, pragmatic unit, survival metric unit. And already I explained in Viterbi decoder, ad compare select unit is having iterative operations. And this unit, due to this iterative operation, this unit has become very, very complex. It is a bottleneck of the any problem. So if you are looking to particular this application, if the code rate is 1 by 2 or 1 by 3, so at a particular state, only two states are going to be incoming. But here the constraint length is 7 and my states is 64. So every state is receiving 8 incoming path, and along with this, we need to add up 8 BM plus PM to get the final PM. So that's why automatically the system has become more complex. This is the ACS butterfly. So I'm getting 8 PMs and 8 PMs, and this are going to be add up and finding out the maximum of it. Then, just to overcome, these are the traditional, if you are looking, working on traditional way, these problems are persist. But if you want to mitigate it, then there will be a threshold generator unit. So what is the work of this threshold generator unit? Basically, it is generating PM of plus T. This is a threshold value. If a incoming path matrix is less than or equal to this particular value, then only it is going for the further calculation. And if it is greater, it will be purged. So then what is happening with the help of this architecture, it will be reduced, it will be increasing the speed because the calculation become minimized. The path matrix which are having major values, not going to be the computations. So automatically, we are sacrificing some hardware, but we are increasing the speed. So this is the basically threshold generator unit, which is based on minimum PMG and minimum PMG. So this is the classification. So 64 path matrix are there. These are classified on the cluster 0, cluster 1, cluster 2, cluster 4, cluster 3. So how we are classified? If they were in mod 4 equals to 0, so they were coming into the one category. If mod 4 is 1, then one category. So classification of PM is important to work on the threshold generator unit. And similarly, as we are working on the 16 branch matrix, so 16 branch matrix is also working on this classification. equation, mod x, mod 4 equals to 0, mod 4 equals to 1, mod 4 equals to 2x. So both PMs and PMs are being classified. This is the pressure generator unit architecture, and in this architecture, the clusters, I have already explained how we are classifying the PM clusters, and we need to compare this, and this architecture we need to implement. I implemented also this in PhD, and after implementation of this, I am getting the value of PM opt with a threshold value T. Now, in this pre-computation architecture, this will be known to be two-step pre-computation architecture, which is reported in my base paper. And here, the delay, and if you are looking to this unit, this is divided into two parts. This is the right, left and right part. So, time delay for the left part and right part, I calculated, this will be the T left and T right. These are the two equations I am getting. Now, after finding out or purging out a particular PM value, whether it is working for the next state or not, or next cycle or not, I have decided to give flags to the path matrix unit. Then what will happen? The states which are greater than 2 PM of plus T is having flag 0, which is less than to this particular value is having flag 1. So all these 64, 0, 1, 0, 1 values I am supplying to the survivor matrix unit. From this survivor matrix unit, I am able to get the final state, and from that final state, I need to trace back, and then I will get by demapping and by demodulating, I get my original data. So here I am finding the final state, and by with the help by supplying the values of flag 0, 1. This SME unit is nothing but a 64 to 6 priority encoder, which is based on some.
What is that SME?
Survivor matrix unit. So
some places. Because that's what I noticed in the thing.
Yeah.
If you have done it in the beginning, okay, one place or something, you may have to repeat it so that the NEETA not have to go back and check what is it. It will take time to go back and then.
If there are two methods, these are two methods.
No. Expansion of them, that's not what I meant.
Expansion of?
SMU, what is it? Because suddenly there are a lot of notations are there.
Okay.
Suddenly when I was going through the thing, the flow of it, I had to retrace back to check the thing, what is that?
Retrace back. So
see, what is SMU now, it is not known here, correct?
Okay.
You would have referred somewhere.
Yes.
So back, you have to retrace to see that what is that SMU. Symbols you are using it, correct? All
yeah.
Acronyms what you are yeah. using it,
yes, ma'am.
Which is defined elsewhere, but you have to go back to check that where it is defined. That is one thing in the flow what I noticed.
So ma'am, from this unit, from this ACSU unit,
see, you are talking about ACSU, ACSU
yeah.
unit.
So ma'am, this
what
is
that expansion of the thing, where is it?
Add compressor
expansion. So where you have defined it, what I am asking. In the report also it is some creations are missing actually. In the sense what I am telling is, if I am referring to the current architecture,
yes.
So whatever you talk about this acronym, where it has been explained, I have to go lot way back. That's what I meant. So usually what we do is, if you have defined it there, in the present chapter if there is relevance, once it is going to be mentioned, because I can search it there itself.
Ma'am, in project report I mentioned the all acronyms.
See, that's what you have to go back, way back and do the thing.
Yes.
The trend what we usually say to our students also is that,
okay, ma'am,
please explain in the current scenario once.
Okay.
After that you can use the all the abbreviations, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So that we need not have to retrace so many pages back to see what is it defined as.
Sorry, ma'am.
That is what I'm commenting, that's it. Nothing else.
Yes, ma'am. Sorry, I'm making things. Now the survivor matrix unit is named SMU is the survivor matrix unit. So this survivor matrix, from where I'm getting this survivor matrix? From add compare select unit, ACSU. And from this unit I'm getting a 1-bit flag to compute the final state, and also a 3-bit of information is going to be to store into the memory to finally again trace back and get the original information. So here I did only to find out the final state.
Can we go to the overall block diagram? diagram once, or shall I see the
recap? Yes, ma'am.
Your resume unit is not.
Ma'am, it's inside this vitobic model because this is one of the part of vitobic.
Complete vitobic model where it is explained.
This is my tablet decoder.
That is what I am telling. See, you have to go free back and then keep checking the thing. Okay. You are now explaining ACS unit, SMU and then PM.
So PM unit is incorporated with ACS unit because path matrix unit we need to compute the final path matrix here.
One second, go back. Why don't you keep the explanation there, it's an expansion of those. In the vital PU bit. Not here. No. We are going much back. Go to the vital PU bit.
Vital PU.
So here you give water.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So then you can say you are explaining it in the next one.
Then they will be the departing unit. The demapping unit is working. This side they are mapping into the receiver transmitter end. Similarly, I need to work with the demapping of the signals. So whatever selected path coming from auxiliary trolley, depending on the final state, then I am resolving the mapping equation and getting the original bits. Then the last unit is a differential decoder. The bits we already encoded at the transmitter end, we need to differentially decode. Then this is the RTL view of the TCM decoder I am implemented in the HTA.
Is that TCM now I last?
This is trellis coded modulation. TCM is trellis coded modulation. And these are some results I
have. I forgot quite long. That's
right. So I direct work coming onto my findings. As I already told you, there are 64 states, ma'am. So if there is 64 states, so how many ACS units required? We require 64 ACS units. So, by close observation of the 64 units, I found that because I am using what? I am using auxiliary trolley concept. And I am also doing the cluster segmentation of path matrix unit and branch matrix unit. So, if you are looking onto the symmetry of PM unit and BM unit, then you will find that there is a set of 8 particular states which are receiving same PMs. So, if they are receiving same PMs, then but auxiliary and butterflies is to be same. So instead of making 64 different ACS butterfly, I will work with only eight ACS butterfly. So
is it reflected in the report?
Yes, ma'am.
Whatever you are explaining.
Yes, ma'am. It is reflected. So 64 are 8, and such states are divided into 8 groups. And instead of 64, I am working with 8. So this is one of my finding. Then these are some. Actually, this is bigger diagram, but it's small. So I plus make the group of such states and they will share the same architecture. And what is the advantage to sharing this architecture? There will be improvement in the slice utilization or device utilization ratio. There is an improvement in delay also. Then the second finding I did with my project is that there will be a two-step pre-computation method. Although this is the additional hardware I required for the T algorithm based vitobic decoder, but what is happening in earlier version, they are computing into the two cycles, and that's why the name is two-step pre-computation. And if you are working with two-step pre-computation method, there will be decrease in the clock speed of the 11% and in comparison to full trace valley trellis vitobic decoder, and the hardware increase in approximately 70%. So what I did, instead of working with two clock cycles, I worked with single clock cycle. So automatically the delay hardware is to be conserved by me, and if the delay hardware is conserved, then instead of comparing 16 branch matrix at the input, I compare only the 4 branch matrix. So because due to the similarity, the result is going to be altogether same. So what I did, instead of 16, I am working with the 4 VMs comparison. So that's why the automatically the T left and T right that I got in 2-step pre-computation is going to be give this. So automatically my delay is going to be reducing. So the architecture there was an architecture, I modified it and I instead of comparing 16, I compared only minimum 16, minimum 16, minimum 16, and then I got the results. Now, if you are looking for the delay calculation, the whole system, the above one is my the base paper system. So there I am getting delay in this 3.966, and here I am getting 2.575. The whole I worked on 13.2 cells, and the vertex 6 FPGA I used.
The speed scale is also same thing, no? Same.
Yeah, it's minus 1. Then this is the resource utilization. If you are looking, ETR 13 is my base paper. So resource utilization, I got also improvement in pursuit of this. There's slice register count, there's LUT count, and post PR times. So some improvement I got. Then the major part. The major part of my system is to work on the dynamic power. So in the reported one, the reported system or existing system, these are the dynamic power. There you get the dynamic power. And if you calculating or summing up all these things, I'm getting 0.252. And in my system, due to some modification, I am getting 0.05. So some modification in power also I got. And this is a graphical representation. And this is the
blue
overall.
Blue represents your HE. Blue represents your HE.
Blue represent is base paper, and red represent proposed.
What I see in the report is blue is missing. Okay, I see the. All of it is almost blue is missing, only one or two places. That's why I was wondering. Here there is a thing, power consumption and things, so this is PR performance, there it is there. In most of the cases, please check, some places blue is missing.
Okay ma'am, I need to work on
it. In few places it is available. I thought if it is overlapping with the green, okay, but I don't see the blue tint at all, so just check that.
This one, SNR value?
This one is... PPS means yes. You basically have your thing. So only you are seeing
this is overlap. This is overlap. So the base can be used to
I don't know why color it's perfect as a color. It's not this is a color. And the rest of the paper we can include this. I don't know whether it is overlap.
Oh, yeah, it's overlap.
But we have to mention it somewhere. Yes. In when you are putting this way. Because if you take black and white, you will not see. Here also see it is not so. That's why I was counting the colors.
So I just change some n value. Simple sample values I will change, then it will skip the overlap.
Yeah, this thing is missing.
They both are overlapping
with
each other.
Which one it has overlapped, it is not so. This will be a little bit take care of it and then show the or somewhere we have to mention. Here, see if it is more than it should have been like this, correct? That is what not seen in the first product. So that's why I went through all the graphs and then I realized it.
So, these are the overall supply power and percent power summary I got. And I'm, as I told ma'am, I'm working on this quicksand power, leakage power. And the speed, finally I just quoted that I need to improve the speed. So in the reported system, 770 was on the system. I took that speed from this base paper. And this is the paper onto which my system is based. So here the reported speed, data rate is 867. And I'm getting 1.98 per second. So my conclusion is,
checking your table also, okay. At that I missed it actually.
Ma'am, after working on the settings and symbols and all, I concluded that I get the system which is having minimum architecture, and I implemented this, and the proposed system method reduces the count of slice register by 6.2% and 13.2%. So I will be able to achieve what I decided. In a way, in the future work, I need to implement this with the hardware one. Then again, I try to reduce the leakage power. And if I need to work more and get the more precise result, and if I get this, then I go for patent also.
Have you thought of the IEEE?
Yes, ma'am. IEEE?
After hardware implementation, you can try the IEEE.
Transitions.
Industry level points.
Okay. Yeah, these are my publications. Thank you.